When you're designing an integration, you may need to use a while action. A while action will test a condition, and if that condition is true, it'll execute one or more steps that you've defined. Then it'll test the condition again. If it's still true, it'll execute the steps again, and so on. It'll continue like that until the condition tests false. Let's look at a simple example. We have an integration that uses a REST trigger to receive an incoming message. Then, after some steps that we're about to define, it'll return that message. We're going to add steps that'll read the incoming message one character at a time, starting from the last character. It'll add that character to a new reverse message and then return the original message in that reversed order. To do that, first we create two variables using an assign action. We initialize the first variable to the length of the incoming message so that it's pointing to the last character position of that message. We initialize the second variable to an empty string, and that's where we're going to store the reverse message as we build it one character at a time. Now we add the while action to the integration and configure its test condition in the expression builder. In the left-hand pane, we see the two variables we just created, as well as a third automatically created variable that represents the incoming message. Remember that we're using the character position variable to point to the current character to read. We'll decrement that variable by 1 with each iteration of the loop. If it's greater than 0, there are characters left to process, and we want the loop to execute again. And then when it finally equals 0, we want the loop to exit. We validate the condition, close the expression editor, and exit. Now we configure the steps inside the while loop that'll build the reverse message. To do that, we use an assign action to update the reverse message variable by concatenating its current value and the character at the position indicated by the character position variable. Then, we decrease the character position variable by 1 to point to the previous character in the message variable. And that's the body of our while loop. When it's done, the while loop tests that condition again, and if the character position variable is greater than 0, it executes again. Whenever a character has finally been processed, the character position variable will be equal to 0, and when it is, the loop will exit. Remember that our integration is configured to return the message variable, the original incoming string. So, outside the while loop, we add a mapping action to copy the value of the reverse message variable to the original message variable. After we activate the integration, we run a test to be sure it runs correctly. We enter a sample message and initiate the test. The loop processes each of the characters in the message, and a reverse string is returned successfully. That's everything I had planned to say about the while action. Looks like it's time to end the video.